Interrupts are great for reacting to things when they actually happen. Remember, normally a PLC reads the inputs, executes all of its logic, and then updates its outputs. We call that a scan. So what do you do if an input comes and goes during the scan? Well, you miss it, because a PLC only reads signals at the top of the scan. Or maybe you need to respond to that signal right now and can't wait until the bottom of the scan. So if you need to catch a fast signal or respond immediately to a signal, interrupts are the answer. Why? Because once you set up an interrupt, it responds whenever the event occurs. It literally tells the PLC to stop whatever it's doing and go do this right now. It doesn't wait until the top of the scan or the bottom of the scan to do something. And the interrupt can occur at any time during the scan. And DoMore Designer makes using interrupts really easy. I've connected a simple push-button switch to input 0 on this DoMore Bricks PLC, so we'll use that to trigger the interrupt. In a dashboard, I click on Interrupts, and let's assign event 1 to respond to this push-button press. Enable the interrupt, and we want input 0 to be our trigger, and let's look for the rising edge. Now, we haven't defined the routine that's going to service this interrupt. We could have done that over here if we had thought of it ahead of time, but this button right here takes us to the exact same dialog. Let's give it a name. We call this an interrupt service routine, or ISR for short. DoMore Designer knows we want an ISR, so we just hit create. The name gets automatically dropped in here, and we're good to go. This little equation says an ISR named ISR event 1 will be executed when it sees the positive going edge of x0. It won't wait for top or bottom of scan, it'll do it immediately. So let's do a little experiment. At the top of scan, let's clear D0 and then add a loop that increments D0 1,000 times. In the interrupt service routine, or ISR, let's copy D0 into D1. That'll record where in the loop we were when the interrupt occurred. Except all that. Let's see, we haven't actually connected to the PLC yet, so I'll go ahead and take care of that. Make sure the PLC is not in run mode and write it out to the PLC. I'll reach over and flip the switch on the PLC to run, and we see that the PLC is running. So how long does it take for the PLC to increment D0 1,000 times? Well, click on Info, and we see it takes on average about 7.6 milliseconds. Let's bring up a data view and monitor D0 and D1. Now remember, the data view updates at the end of each scan, so all we see is D0 after it's been incremented 1,000 times. When I hit the push button switch that triggers the interrupt, D0 gets copied to D1, and we can see where the loop counter was when the interrupt occurred. How fast does the interrupt respond? Well, the time it takes for the DoMore to react to an interrupt is what we call interrupt latency. And look at this, there's an ISR structure member that tells you what the latency is. In this example, it's taking the DoMore about 3 microseconds to react to the event. How cool is that? You can also see how long it takes for the ISR to run, whether it's been triggered or not, if it's currently inhibited, and how many times the ISR has been run. Everything you could want to know about an ISR is right there. Now remember, the ISR is literally stopping the regular scan, doing its thing, and then letting the scan continue. So it's really important to keep an eye on the execution time and make sure it doesn't take too much time away from your regular scan. Looks like our ISR is taking this much time out of our 7.6 millisecond loop. That's almost no impact on our scan time at all, which is exactly what we want. So normally, you just want to record something in the ISR, like we recorded the loop counter in D1, then do something with that in another task or a program later as part of the regular scan. Don't let that interrupt service routine get too long. A few other things to keep in mind about interrupts. An interrupt that triggers an event can't re-trigger the same event while its interrupt service routine is still running. That event will be lost. If an event for a different interrupt occurs while the ISR is running, then that event will be processed after the current interrupt is done. Another good reason to keep your interrupt service routine as short as possible. Can you do anything you want in an ISR? Well, no. You can't do looping, for example. Why? Because ISRs don't yield, so the loop has to run to completion, which takes a long time, so they simply aren't allowed in an ISR. Asynchronous instructions aren't allowed in an ISR. Why? Because asynchronous instructions require multiple scans to run, and you never know when or even if an ISR is going to run. So asynchronous instructions don't make any sense in an ISR. Now, you really don't need to remember all of this. Do More Designer will tell you if you try to use an instruction that doesn't work in an ISR. Well, that ought to be enough for a quick intro to interrupts in the Do More Bricks PLC. In the remaining videos in this series, we'll take a close look at exactly how to use the other kinds of interrupts and then cover some loose ends like configuring interrupts while the PLC is running. And if you need any help with the Bricks PLC, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There's lots of automation professionals there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis. Spend less, do more with Automation Direct.